My coverage of CES 2024 is brought to you by Cooler Master, Kioxia, Asus, and Gigabyte.
Welcome everyone to the Heights Room area, booth, suites at the Convention Center at Venetian. We are gonna cover their new products. If you guys watched my coverage of Height back at Computex, they've been working on the thickest all-in-one liquid cooler that has ever come to market, and they are now actually able to sell it. So we're gonna take a look at the final version of that. They also have a brand new keyboard, and who likes to say keyboard when you're referencing a keyboard? Let's shorten that up for efficiency's sake. It's called the Keeb, TKL, even more efficient since it doesn't have a, it's 10 keyless. Okay, let's go look. So let's start over here with the main event. This is the thick Q60. Specifically, the all-in-one liquid cooler that we see right here is the thick Q60. So although we're still working with 120 millimeter fans here, this is a 240 millimeter radiator by measurement of the two fans. It is much thicker, not just the radiator itself, but the fans are 32 millimeters thick, whereas this type of fan is usually 25 millimeters thick. And then the radiator is 52 millimeters thick, whereas those radiators typically top out around the 38 millimeter range. By increasing the girth of this AIO, they say that it can perform on par with a 360 millimeter all-in-one. So as long as you can fit that thickness in your case, you can get away with a little bit less area in terms of the fan configuration. Height has also done a lot of work on the fans themselves. They have an individual temperature sensor in each fan, and that will tie into the software so you can get a good idea of the temperature of the air that is going into your case or out of your case, or even all around your case if you're gonna set up something similar to this. This is just sort of a broken out example of how to maximize the controller. Up here at the top of the radiator, you have a control unit that actually has three channels, but one of the channels for it is dedicated to controlling the LCD screen right here. Two of the channels can be broken out and connected with these Type-C connectors, or they also have Type-M connectors, Nexus Link Type-M connectors to be specific. So the M means magnetic, and those can just snap on and snap off, so you can daisy chain the fans together, and you can also daisy chain RGB LED strips beyond that. So for example, this setup right here, we have a wire coming from the bottom of these fans. It's connecting up the four fans across the bottom. It has another connector right here that's leading to these LEDs, powering those all the way up and around the side, and even up over the top. The LED strips are available in two varieties. We have a 1 foot LS10 that has 30 LEDs, and we have a 3 foot LS30 that has 90 LEDs. And now we've come to the end of that chain right here. But there are actually two channels available from this controller. The second one is going up here for this top group of fans, and then passing over here down to this lower group of fans. Oh, and then they even passed it through off of that back to a strip going across the back of this table, and that is one of the 3 foot varieties that is suitable for a larger case doing a wraparound, or if you want to light up your desk as well. And they have actually a pretty cool desk setup showing off some of their RGB LEDs over in the corner. That's pretty cool. That's where we started this video. So with the two channels available here, you can connect up to 18 devices on one of those channels, or if you populate both of those channels, it goes up to 32 devices. As mentioned, that third channel on this controller is piping over to control the LCD. It's a 5-inch LCD, 720 resolution, 300 nits brightness, and it is an IPS display with 60 hertz refresh rate. And you might also notice that since it sort of floats out here on this little arm, you can rotate it. So depending on where you have your motherboard set up or where you have your computer, you can actually position this to angle towards you so you can actually see that LCD. Of course, if you have lots of RGB lights, you might have a difficult time controlling them unless you have software to do that. And so Height has been hard at work to further develop and refine their Nexus software. Right now we can see it set up in cooling mode, so it has access to all of those fans. Look how many fans are connected and being controlled right now and reporting their RPMs and their rotation speed. And then for lighting control, you can have the visualizer here. So right now they're playing some music in the background, which hopefully isn't causing a copyright infringement strike. That can be visualized here, and then you can choose different areas of that visualization to be reflected in your RGB LEDs for the devices that are connected. But you can also have this tied into like a video playback, or if you're watching a music video or something like that, and that will of course give you ambient lighting with your RGBs that matches what you're seeing on the screen. Oh, and one other really cool thing about this all-in-one liquid cooler that I find to be an incredibly useful addition is it has dual pumps. Functionally, that's gonna help with the liquid flow rate, so that's part of how they're making this 240 millimeter all-in-one liquid cooler compete with 360 millimeter AIOs. But when I have used AIOs in the past, Most of the time they're fine, but I have had a couple that have had the pump fail. And if a pump fails on an AIO, it can lead to issues with your system because the CPU can overheat, and then as the system's trying to boot, the CPU can overheat again for shutdown. It can cause issues with an operating system. It can be a big mess. I did confirm with Height that the dual pumps in this unit do have a failover mode, so if one of them fails, it's going to give you a red warning on the display here. It will also reflect that over on the Height software if you are running that. It can continue to operate with just the single pump, that is just fine, but it gives you the ability to see if a pump has failed, and it also makes sure that your system is going to continue to run even with that failed pump, so you can get a replacement unit and get yourself set up and not actually have like a corrupted OS. So I thought that was a really nice addition. And then the other thing to mention is that if you like the RGB and the aesthetics and the software that they have, but you're not necessarily going to go out and buy the AIO, this does have a $300 MSRP out of the gate, which is a pricey for a liquid cooler, but it does have lots of extra features. But if you don't want that, you can still get the lighting control that does have the ability to control all the light strips and other devices that they have in their ecosystem. For that, they have a sold separately Nexus Portal, and they don't have any units of that that aren't just like embedded in a system, so I'm just showing you here. I showed this at my Computex coverage as well, but that can be purchased standalone, and that will give you three channels of support for lots and lots of RGB and device connectivity. We have one other product here that I wanted to highlight, and that is the Keeb. Look at it. Look how RGB it is. I need to specify, this is the Keeb TKL. It is a 10 keyless keyboard, so you don't have a number pad over here, but you do have your arrow keys and your home print screen and all that. Height has developed their own switches for this keyboard, and they're actually called, get this, fluffy lavender switches. That's right. You can see the mounting post down there is lavender colored. Why do they call them fluffy? Perhaps because of the feel. They do have a nice light feel. They're not clicky switches by any stretch, but they are mechanical. I'd say they have a nice feel, just given my first impressions right here as I type away. Functionally, we also have a dual roller bar up here in the top left, so it's going to default for volume control. You can also control brightness on the right side, but you can also remap these to tie in with, say, video editing software or other software on your PC for other functions. And I also thought it was interesting, these pop off. They have sort of a flat rubberized texture right now, which feels pretty nice, but they're going to have the option to maybe swap those out with something with a little bit more texture. So that might be a swap in or an add-in upgrade in the future. Apart from extensive and glorious RGB across the entire keyboard, which is also further diffused and dissipated by the fact that it has a clear housing, which I think is unique amongst keyboards, and I think also might be like one of those like design aesthetic choices that you guys may or may not be into. So let me know as you're looking at my footage here. I'm trying to capture this as much as I can, even though we have lots of different lighting situations going on. Do you guys like the clear look? Is that suitable for you? And also, what do you think about going like full-size keyboard, 10 keyless, like the 65%, I personally find the 65% boards to be a little bit too limiting for my taste. I like to at least have the dedicated arrow keys. And for keyboard nerds out there, I am told that these have Duroc V2 stabilizers and they are pre-lubed with Crytox. Does that mean anything to you? If it does, you're probably a keyboard enthusiast and you probably actually know way more about keyboards than I do. But if there are any of you guys in the comments, I would love to hear your feedback because honestly, the niche keyboard space is something that I've dabbled in, but haven't really like gone fully down the rabbit hole on. So let me know what you think about some of Height's decisions with this keyboard, and if you think it is worth the MSRP of $179.99, $180. This is available right now. But guys, that's gonna wrap it up for my coverage here at the Height booth suite thing. What do you call these rooms?
Meeting rooms.
Meeting rooms. I'm here with Adam from PC World. I'm going to do an interview with him. So if you guys aren't subscribed to PC World, go ahead and do that. Check out the interview. He's been interviewing people all week as well as doing just insane amounts of coverage. I look at his work and I'm like, why don't you do less? But, you know, what else can
we
you do?
We should. I have too much fun doing it. I think that's the problem is that I'm like, oh, that's cool. Oh, we should do something on that. That's pretty fun. So
it's a dedication to the craft. So thank you guys for watching this video. Thumbs up button and all that. Check out links in the description. Buy stuff from my store. Subscribe. We'll see you on the next video.
Buy stuff from the Full Nerd Award winning merch.
You're right.
Merch
I got Full Nerd Award for my store. Look, we got new.
Oh, is that new?
This is the...
I dig it.
Slightly new.
Okay, I gotta get one of those.
Anyway, that's I'll send you one. Okay, that's all for now. Bye, guys.
Yeah, no.
Just get down in frame.